Hey, what's up, New York? This is your host, L.I.E. This is the N.Y.K. Culture Show. How you doing today? Hey, we in the wintertime. Look, if I have to watch one more game where my quarterback of the New York Jets is throwing three interceptions, I'm going to kill myself, all right? Let's get the NBA season started. Oh, my God. New York Knicks will be playing next week against the Indiana Pacers, our dreaded rivals. You know what happened. Reggie Miller the choke, John Starks the headbutt. So, you know, it's going to be very interesting. Let's go, Knicks. Now, I want to kick off the show today with one of my favorite segments. Now, it's called This or That, where we do comparables, two different players, and who do you choose, all right? So let's kick the show off today with Bernard King and Carmelo Anthony, okay? Ooh, yes. You know, these are two beasts, all right? Now, Carmelo Anthony, you know, he played for the Knicks, played great, brought us back to the playoffs. Bernard King was that great scorer. Just wish he could have played with Patrick Ewing. I'm telling you, that's the main thing I dreamed of. But let's get to the stats, folks. All right? We're going to talk about Bernard King first. Bernard King, field goals made, 7,830, folks. All right? Compared to Carmelo Anthony, he made 9,800. Oh, my God. That's amazing. So he topped him on that. Let's give it to Melo. All right? Field goal percentage. Field goal percentage, 51.8 for Bernard King, the great King. All right? Field goal percentage for Carmelo, 44.7. And it's amazing because with Bernard King, you know, I don't see anybody shooting over 50% of their field goals. All right? So he's a great scorer. He finishes at the basket. All right? So let's talk about free throws made. Free throws made. Bernard King made 3,972 free throws. Okay? As compared to, Carmelo Anthony. Melo. He makes 6,188 free throws. Okay? So these guys are going to the hole. And, you know, they're not just scoring other ways, but they're scoring on the free throw line, too. So you foul them, it's pretty much automatic. So let's talk about free throw percentage with Bernard King as regards to him. He has 73 free throw percentage and Carmelo has 81.4. Okay, so like I said, that's pretty much automatic when he goes to the hole, when you foul him. Okay, so let's talk about three-pointers made, which is, you know, everybody loves the three. That's what the game is based on now. You got the stretches, stretch fives. And, you know, it's three-point happy. This is a three-point happy league now. But in their time, you know, you had Carmelo and King. King, his 3 points made were 23, all right? This dismal number. King really didn't have to shoot threes. You know what happened. You know, he goes to the hole, and he finishes at the basket. So his mid-range game was excellent. So 3-point percentage. Let's just go 3 points made for Carmelo. I'm sorry. Let's recap that. Bernard King had 23. So Carmelo Anthony, what do you think he has? 1,582. Okay, that's how many he made. So that's just blows him out the water. It's not even comparison with threes, all right? Because that's not Bernard's game. So also, 3-point percentage. Bernard King, obviously. It's going to be a bad number. 17.2. Never see those numbers, really, because he obviously wasn't interested in the three. So, 3-point percentage for Melo, 35.3. Okay? So, you know, there's no comparison there. Give it up two categories for Melo. So, rebounds. Rebounds are key. Who's out there hustling? Who's crashing the boards? You know, who's helping out? Bernard King, 5.8. 5.8 rebounds, modest. Carmelo Anthony, 6.3 rebounds, okay? Let's get to the points, which is, you know, the cute numbers. It's the pretty, it's the sexy numbers, the points. 22.5 for Bernard King, okay? As opposed to Carmelo, 23. So Bernard King was obviously a better scorer than him, okay? And then we go to assists. Who's sharing? Okay, Bernard King, 3.3 assists per game for his average. Carmelo Anthony, 2.8. All right? The comparison is yours. You know, you like who you like, but it's like, if you were starting a team, who would you choose? Who's going to be your guy? Who would you, you know, go in the trenches with? Who would you depend on? As far as everything else, if you give Bernard King the ball, obviously, he's going to score at a high rate. So, now, let's go to the other group of guys that, you know, I loved watching as a fan. That's John Starks and Allen Houston, okay? And these guys are probably, you know, probably one of the best, two of the best Knicks shooters of all time. But, you know, we have McGuire and Bradley. I get those on my old-timers. And I want to hear your thoughts on that, too, also. Who's the best shooter of all time? But as far as two guards, these guys stand out. And that's John Starks and Allen Houston, okay? We know Allen Houston from the big shot, you know, the big finger roll and the punch. Miami, I love that moment. That was a great Knicks moment. Starks with the dunk and things like that, you know, going head up with Jordan. But let's get to the stats on these gentlemen, all right? John Starks, his field goal percentage, field goals made actually, 3,953, as opposed to Houston, field goals made 85. So, I don't know. I think Starks had a longer tenure. Maybe that was it. But, you know, we'll go to the next stat, which is field goal percentage. Field goal percentage, John Starks at 41.2. And field goal percentage, Allen Houston, 41.5. So, it's really no big gap there. I mean, they're both, like, pretty much on the same level. They score, you know, in the 40 percentage range. So, free throw percentage. You have John Starks, 76.9. Allen Houston, 83.7. Okay? Pretty good. Those are pretty good field goals. Like I said, they're pretty much automatic if you're close to 80 or over 80, baby, basically. So, 3 points made. You have, I mean, this is crazy. You have John Starks, 1,222. Allen Houston, 31 as a Knick. All right. Now, I don't, you know, John Starks shoots a lot, but that's a tremendously huge number as opposed to Houston. So I'm giving John Starks that 3 points made. He's more, you know, you could depend on him, basically. Except game seven, but we love you, John. All right. Let's talk about 3 point percentage. John Starks, 34. Allen Houston, 38.8. So his percentage-wise, Allen Houston would make him, you know, basically more. So, rebounds. I mean, not really a sexy stat, but like I said, want to see who's hustling? John Starks, 2.5. Allen Houston, 1.2. So, and the points, John Starks, 12.5. Allen Houston, 11.9. Assists, Wu Sharon. John Starks, 3.6. Allen Houston, 2.1. All right? So that's this edition of This and That. I would like to thank you guys for supporting. Check out the show every week. You know, and I'm really proud, you know, just to be off the cuffs. I'm really proud of Leon Rose, what he's doing, how they're building a great culture and blending young players with new players. Also, GM Scott Perry. And it seems like, you know, to me personally, my observation is that Dolan is really entrusting his front office and, you know, management to do the right thing. And using their expertise, you know, they've worked wonders. And I think they've moved into a positive place moving forward. All right. And they have the right players around. It's just, you know, developing everything. So this is the latest edition of NYK Culture. Like, share, and also subscribe, everybody. We got great things coming up. This is your show, and it's not my show. It's your show. I'm just your host, L.I.E., and I appreciate you for being here with me. Enjoy your night. Let's get ready. Go Knicks. Go New York. Go New York. Go. All right? This is NYK Culture. Take care.